focus and focus and focus, they just like suck up all that energy, all right? So we're gonna have to spit some more out. So are you ready for some comedy?
Yeah!
So we have the host of the podcast, Left Hand Right Brain, here with us tonight. Let's give it up for J.D. Lopez.
Hello, everybody. Hello. I'm J.D. Lopez. Yes, yes. I'm a proud Latino man. Woo! My family came. That's fine. That's fine. Are you familiar? Not so familiar, I guess. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. But, you know, I identify as a proud Latino man, you know. But my brother, he's Mexican. Okay. And some of you guys are like, what's the difference? Let's just say, mi hermano es incarcerado. Okay. All right. Not a lot of Spanish speakers. That's okay. BC's in jail. It's okay. He's not getting out. All right. That's always a fun one. He's not getting out. It's okay. If you don't speak Spanish, that's okay. I'm actually one of those Latinos that can't speak a lot of Spanish. You know, it's really kind of a cultural incarcerado for me there. Yeah. But, you know, well, what's really messed up is my brother. He went to jail for selling pot. And I work at a marijuana dispensary. So, yeah, it's kind of ironic. Yeah, but, you know, there's a lot of differences in our lives, you know. Well, before I get to that one, it makes it real weird, you know, when he calls. I'll be home sometimes visiting, you know, and he'll call, and I'll talk to him. And it makes it real awkward. He calls him, and we'll be like, hey, Angelo, what's going on, man? How you doing? Be like, hey, fool. Like, I'm on the inside now. Where are you at? Like, oh, I'm outside, just at dad's house. It kind of feels like jail, am I right? That's not funny, fool. Oh, right, okay. So, how you doing in there? You staying safe, huh? Doing your thing? Like, well, you know, fool, like, got in a fight the other day, the guard wasn't around, got a little roughed up. What you know about it? Like, oh, dude, you know, that sounds violent. I was at work the other day, you know, and, this customer came in, he got really upset that we didn't have the mango, blueberry, wheat gummies he liked. You know, he's not making a big deal about it, he started yelling. Then actually the guard came in and took care of it. Never mind. Yeah, that's always an awkward conversation. Yeah, but we did different, directions in our lives. Like, you know, when we were little, he joined a gang, I joined a guild. he ran drugs, I ran a bingo night. And he's always like, you're too nerdy to join gangs, so he always told me. But I like to think of it as like we just joined different organized crime families. You know, I joined he actually got jumped into the game by some guy named Lalo, and you know, I just paid my dues to Uncle Sam. You know, they call him a drug dealer, they call me a butt tender. Joke's on you, Angelo. But a lot of people are like, how'd you get the job at the dispensary? What was the interview process like, you know? And it's like most jobs, you know, but I mean, like, stoner culture just always seeps through, you know? Like, I went in to the shop to go do the interview, and I didn't know who the manager was, you know? And I couldn't tell. Everyone's wearing pajama bottoms and hoodies, you know? It's like, you know, who's the manager? Just pro tip for everybody, if you need to know who the manager is at the dispensary, it's always the person with the longest dreads is going to be the manager, okay? Yeah, so I finally figure out who the manager is. She takes me to the manager's room, okay, the office. It looks like a college dorm, all right? There's a mini fridge, a bong on the table. I capture some weird stains on it, black light, posters of a wizard. Yeah, it looks really cool, you know? So she plops down on the couch, starts asking me all the regular questions, but then, you know, all that stoner stuff just comes out, you know? Like, halfway through the interview, she just looks up at me, long pause, she goes, what time is it? I think Chipotle's open right now? Can you do math? I was like, yeah, well, it's 2:30, so yeah, I think Chipotle's open. She's like, whoa, you're good. Pretty quick. So I'm going to ask you this question. She goes, this one usually stumps people, but I think you're ready for it. If you could smoke weed with anyone alive or dead, who would it be? I was like, whoa, anyone alive or dead? Oh, wow. Okay. I'm going through his mental Rolodex. I'm like, who's stoner's like? Cheech and Chong, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I don't know. And then I was like, oh no, I got it. If I could smoke with anyone alive or dead, it'd be you guys. She was like, whoa! She had a coughing fit for about 5 minutes, you know. And she came out of it. She's like, so anyway, that's why I think it'd be perfect for this job. It's like, you're interviewing me. Did you forget that already? And she's like, all right, right, right. But where do you see me in 5 years? It's like, probably smoking some hella weed, huh? We high-fived. And that's how I got the job. All right, guys, thanks so much for listening to me. I'm Jamie Lopez. This is your host, Frank, right here. It's called Left Hand Right Brain. It's an exploration of creativity, you know. But I just get local creatives. We talk about the creative process and also just, you know, what's going on in our lives. You know, having fun, kicking back, having a good time. But I did also want to plug. I have a monthly show on a monthly show, Media Information Cafe. It's the last Saturdays of the month. It's called Comedy Save the Video Star. It's a music video comedy mashup show. Last Saturdays of the month, because it's always a good time. And you can find the podcast at lefthandrightbrainpod.com or deborahpodcast.net. It's part of the Deborah Podcast Network. Thank you.
Whatever, Jamie. Thanks so much for being here. All right, so for our next comedian, she has been gracing stages in Denver for 2 years, but really she just wants to be around me, you know? It's typical behavior, right? Wonderful, everyone. Let's give it up.